Hello students, I am your biology lecturer. Today in this class we can discuss the most important question of chapter number 2nd. Okay, second chapter, that is a sexual reproduction in flowering plant. Okay, we already completed all the topics of the second chapter. Today we can discuss the important questions. Please prepare answer for all these questions. These are very important question. These are the expected question for your final examination. Okay. First question, it is a most repeated question. What is tapetum? Tapetum is a innermost layer of a anther. Or you can write like this. Tapetum is a innermost layer of a micro sporangium or nothing but the anther. Okay, then second question, what is the function of tapetum? You already know that in the first question, tapetum is the innermost layer of anther. The function of the anther is the nourishment to developing microspores or pollen grains. The pollen grains which are developing inside the anther, that is the microsporangium. Okay, for the development it needs nourishment. Okay, the nourishment is given by tapetum of that anther. Okay, in one line we can say the function of the tapetum is nourishment to the developing pollen grains or a microspores. Microspores and pollen grains are both the same. Okay, we can move to the third question. What is endothecium? Endothecium is a second layer of anther. After the epidermis, next layer is the endothecium. Second most layer of the anther. Okay, which helps in the dehiscence of the anther after maturity. It helps in dehiscence after maturity of anther. Then what is germ pore? Germ pore is a fine and a minute pore present on the pollen grain where the exine is absent, which helps in germination of or formation of pollen tube. The pollen tube emerges out by this germ pore. Okay, germ pore is a small pore like structure present on the pollen grain where there is a absence of pollen grain layer. Okay, next question, what are layers of pollen grains? What are the layers of pollen grains? Pollen grain have the two layers actually. Outermost layer is called as the exine, innermost layer is a intine. Okay, then after the exine and intine you can see the plasma membrane also. Next one, what is sporopollenin? Sporopollenin is a chemical which is present in the exine layer of the pollen grain. Okay, you already know that pollen grain have the two layers. Okay, this is the structure of pollen grain. Pollen grain have the two layers. Outermost is a exine, innermost is a intine. Okay, that exine layer is having the chemical, that is a sporopollenin. It is most resistant chemical. Then next question, what is composition? What is the composition of intine? The exine is made up of sporopollenin. The question will comes like this also. Which chemical is present in the exine layer of pollen grain? Sporopollen. Like that. What is the composition of intine? Intine is the innermost layer. The intine having the pectin and cellulose. Intine is composed of pectin and cellulose. Next question. What is hilum? Hilum is the structure where the funicle and the ovule get attached. Okay. We studied this hilum in the structure of ovule or a megasporangium. Okay. A hilum is a structure where the ovule and the funicles are get attached. Then, next, what is the function of, nucellus? Nucellus function is also same like a tapetum. Okay, nucellus is a nutritive tissue which just surrounds the embryo sac in the ovule, which gives the nourishment or supplies the food for a embryo sac. Next, what is placentation? Placentation is the arrangement of ovules in a ovary. Arrangement of ovules in a ovary is called as a placentation. Then, what are filiform apparatus? Filiform apparatus we studied in a egg apparatus part, which is present in the synergids. Okay, at the chalazal region, you can see the three cells. Two cells are synergid cells. Synergid cells have the thick wall thickenings called as a finger-like wall thickenings called as a filiform apparatus, which helps in a entry of pollen tube during the fertilization or post-pollination. Next question, what is the egg apparatus? Egg apparatus we can see in the chalazal part of the ovule. Egg apparatus means presence of two synergids plus one egg nucleus. Okay, inside the synergids you can see the filiform apparatus. Okay, next question, what is autogamy? Autogamy is one of the type of a pollination. Here, the transfer of pollen grains from flower of a same plant. Autogamy is a kind of a pollination where we can see the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the same flower. This pollination occurs in a same flower. The same means in case of bisexual plant, the anthers, the pollen grains from the anther of the same flower transfer to the stigma of the same flower. Okay. Next question. What is ketogamy? Ketogamy is a type of the pollination where we can see the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of another flower of the same plant. In the same plant, we can see the ketogamy. The pollen grains transfer to the stigma of the flower of the same plant. Here, two different flowers are involved in the ketogamy of the same plant. Okay. Next question, what is emasculation? Emasculation is a process of removal of stamens or the anthers from a bisexual plant. Emasculation we discussed in a artificial hybridization topic. Emasculation is a process of removal of stamens from the bisexual plant in order to avoid the cell pollination. Okay, next question, what is triple fusion? Triple fusion is a fusion of one male gamete with a two polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm. Okay, this topic we studied in a double fertilization. Next question, what is endosperm? Endosperm sperm is a nutritive tissue which is formed by the triple fusion, which gives the nourishment or nutrients to the developing embryo. It is triploid in nature. Next question, what is perisperm? After the fertilization in some seeds, the part of the nucellus is this persistent. That part of a nucellus is called as a perisperm. Okay, in the matured seeds. Next question, what is polyembryony? Polyembryony is a presence of a more than one embryo in a single seed is called as polyembryony. Okay, the polyembryony is by the nucellar cells. Many embryos are developed inside the single embryo sac or a single ovule is called as a polyembryony. This much answer is enough for 1 mark. If you need more sentences, means you can add, polyembryony is by the nucellar cells which just surrounds the embryo sac. They starts dividing and enters the embryo sac and develops into a individual embryos. That's why more than one embryo we can see inside the embryo sac. Such type of development is called as a polyembryony. Okay, next question, what is apomixis? Apomixis is a process of formation of seeds without any fertilization. Process of formation of seeds without any fertilization is called as a apomixis. Next, what is dormancy? Dormancy is a inactivate period of an seed. There is no germination. It is due to some internal factors of an seed or external factors like unfavorable conditions. Next question, what is coloriza? Coloriza is a undifferentiated mass of the cells which covers the radical or a root cap. Next question, what is coleoptile? Coleoptile is also undifferentiated mass of the cells which covers the shoot tip of it is a transparent sheet which covers the shoot tip, that is called as a coleoptile. Then what is pericarp? Pericarp is a fruit wall which is by the, initially it is a ovary wall, later after the fertilization it converts into a fruit wall. Next question, what is parthenocarpic fruit? Parthenocarpic fruits are produced by the parthenocarpy, means the fruit production without any fertilization. If question like this, what is parthenocarpic fruit? The parthenocarpic fruit is produced by without fertilization. Okay, next, what is false fruit? False fruits means the fruits are developed at false fruit. The fruits are developed by the other parts of the plant along with the ovary. Okay, next question, what is scutellum? It is very important. Scutellum is a single cotyledon in monocots, or we can say a cotyledon of a monocot plant is called as a scutellum. Next, 3 marks question we can discuss. First question, explain the structure of pollen grain. Okay, For this, you have to draw the Pollengren diagram. In that, you should mention the layers of the Pollengren. Then what is Pollengren? Pollengren is a structure which carries the male gametes, which is covered by three layers. Outermost layer is a exine, second layer is a intine, innermost one is a plasma membrane. Okay, it have the cytoplasm and a nucleus. The exine is made up of sporopollenin, intine is made up of cellulose and a pectin. The sporopollenin is very resistant chemical. Next question, mention the function of different layers of anther. This question will ask like this also, mention the function of different layers of microsporangium. The word microsporangium and anthers both are same. Okay, they mainly anther have the four layers. Outermost layer is a epidermis, next layer is a endothecium. There are 2 to 3 layers of middle layers are present. Next, innermost layer is a tapetum. Okay, you have to mention the function. Epidermis is for a protection, endothecium for a dehiscence of anther, middle layer is also for a protection, tapetum gives the nourishment, which nourishes the developing microspores. Next question, draw a neat label diagram of ovule. Okay, ovule diagram, you have to draw ovule having the integuments, micropylar and chalazal, and inside nucellus tissue. In the nucellus tissue, embryo sac is present. Next, what is egg apertus? Egg apertus is a part of the ovule. Egg apertus is a part of the embryo sac which having the two synergids and a one egg cell at the micropylar region of a ovule. Synergids are having the filiform apertus, which is a finger like wall thickening which helps in the entry of pollen tube at the time of fertilization or a post pollination. Next question, what are the kinds of pollination? Pollinations are mainly three types: autogamy, getenogamy and genogamy. Okay, and also pollination is by many agents. Next question, you have to explain this. Next, what is outbreeding devices? There are three outbreeding division of a one male gamete with a two polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm. Okay, by the syngamy, diploid zygote is formed. Both the process are called as a double fertilization. Okay, next question, what is endosperm? Endosperm is formed by the triple fusion. Triple fusion, it is used nourishment to the developing embryo, which is in triploid nature. Next, what is false and true fruit? We discuss already in the one mark questions. Next, what is apomixis? For 3 marks, you have to explain how the embryo is, means how the seed is formed without any fertilization. Okay, next we can discuss the 5 marks question. In that first one, explain the structure of anther, or explain the structure of young anther, or explain the structure of mature anther. There is a difference. In the young anther, sporogenous tissue is present. In the mature anther, inside the megasporangium, Pollengrens are present. While explaining the structure of megasporangium, I mentioned that if they ask young anther, you should write the sporogenous tissue, or you should draw the sporogenous tissue. If they ask a mature anther, you should mention the pollen grain in that, and in diagram also you should label with the pollen grain. Next, this question will ask like this also. Explain the structure of microsporangium. Don't get confused, guys. Anther and microsporangium both are same. Next question. Explain the process of microsporogenesis. Okay. For this question, you should explain the formation of microspores by the sporogenous tissue. How the sporogenous tissue undergoes to the meiosis to form a dyad, then dyad undergoes to again meiosis second to form a pollen tetrad. Okay, that pollen tetrads are separate to form a individual pollen grain. Okay, next, that question will ask like this also. Explain the process of formation of microspore or a pollen grain. Both are same. Next question. Explain the process of megasporogenesis. It is quite interesting. Megasporogenesis means it is a process of formation of egg. Okay. The microsporogenesis occurs in the ovule. For this, you should draw the diagram. Okay. Initially, at the micropylar end, the megaspore mother cells are present. Those are undergoes to the meiosis to form a megaspore dyads. Then megaspore dyad undergoes to the meiosis second to form a megaspore tetrads. The megaspores in that megaspore tetrad, only one megaspore going to be functional. Other three are get degenerate. Okay. In that megaspore, functional megaspore nucleus undergoes to the free nuclear division to form a 2 nuclei, 4 nuclei, 8 nuclei like this. Then that after 8 nuclei stage, the wall formation occurs to come later they form a complete embryo sac like structure. Okay. For this, you have to write up to 8 cell stage of an embryo sac. Okay. Next question. Explain the structure of embryo sac. In that, you should mention chalazal end, micropylar end. At the chalazal end, 3 cells are present. Those are antipodal cells. At the micropylar end, 3 cells are present. 1 egg cell, 2 synergids, filiform apatus, then central cell. In that, 2 polar nuclei. Next, for this, you should draw the diagram. Next question. That one only. Draw neat labeled diagram of embryo sac. Next question. What is pollination? Pollination is a process of transfer of pollen grains to the stigma of the flower. Next, explain types. Types we already discussed. Next question. Explain the pollen and pistil interaction. Okay, this is very important question. Many times this question comes in a final exam previous years. Pollen and pistil interaction. It is a free fertilization event after pollination. How the pollen grain get attached to the stigma, that pollen sucks the nutrients and food from the stigma, then the pollen tube get germinate and enters inside the embryo sac and releases the 2 male gametes inside the embryo sac. Okay, all these things you should explain. Next question. Explain the diagram of monocot and dicot embryo. Okay, it is also very important question. In the monocot embryo, only single cotyledon and embryogonal axis. In the dicots, 2 cotyledons and embryogonal axis. सेम रैडिकल अंडर रूट टिप, फ्यूमिल अंडर शूट टिप, हाइपोकोटिलेडन, एपिकोटिलेडन।